A long time ago, when Spectrasonics was just about to release the first version of Omnisphere, I made a short interview with Eric Persing for a magazine I was working for at that time. When asking him about what he thought about randomization of sounds, he told me something along the lines that he wants to understand how a sound is built up and why it sounds like it does. Sure, there are times when randomization can be useful, for example, when creating special synth effects. And I can absolutely see how randomization can be used to create unexpected waveforms as fundamental building blocks for your samplers. But using randomization as a shortcut to create sounds and patches often ends up taking longer time than doing it manually. The problem is that you're not getting good quality sounds quickly. After the generation of the sounds, you have to go through all of them, one by one, and clean them up from all the weird side effects that comes from the randomization. Personally, the biggest problem for using randomization is that sound design becomes very boring. Press a button 10 times and maybe find one decent ID that you have to work and polish on before you can release it to the public. Every time I have done this, and believe me, I have tried, randomizing sounds as a form of sound design is so insanely boring that I rather sweep the floors or do the dishes. Remember, one good sound is worth more than 100 mediocre ones. There is happiness in using your mind and your taste to create something new.